should be live.
All right, y'all should be able to hear me. I hope that you can hear me. If you will, let me know in the sidebar or in the comments. Let's see here. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Let me know if you can hear me. Rob Miller's here. We hear you. All right. So, let's see. Let me do something real quick. Just bear with me. I'm having some technical issues. Don't know why I'm having technical issues, but I'm having them. Okay. Do you see on your screen, Extreme Income Catering? Daniel says not hearing. David says hearing. But hi. You may need to refresh your page. Joseph, love your voice. Thank you. I've been working on that voice for 47 years. Let's see. Not seeing or hearing. Yes, yes, yes. We got a lot of people seeing, okay, and hearing. And I assume you see the screen. Let me double check something real quick. I'm going to open up another browser window real quick. Just bear with me. And Jason, while we wait, is going to sing you a song.
Oh, no. I don't want to torture anybody.
All right, so we are live, Jason. We're good.
Good to go.
So they actually can. And here, watch this. You're going to love this. Guess what? I'm glad you're here. Holy moly, it's 2:03. I'm 3 minutes late, Jason.
That's all right.
It's not all right.
We'll take it out of your pay.
We've been how long have we been working on this? 4 or 5 months?
Yeah, it's been a while.
But how long? And then on this webinar, we've been out here for 2 hours straight.
Oh, yeah, just getting set up. And
y'all are fixing to see us.
Yep.
This is crazy. Crazy. Okay, let me see if I can pull up the screen here, and hopefully you can see us. And please let me know in the box, in the comment box. Kevin Wilson's here. Joy's here. Boss Ross Dogs is in the house. He says he can't see or hear anyone. Do you see us right now on your screen? Please tell me you do. David Bloom says he sees us.
Oh, boy.
That's awesome. Because look how good we look.
I don't know about that, but...
So, this is exciting for me. I've been vending for a long time, and I've trained and talked to tens of thousands of vendors. And I've never seen anything like this. Nah. Never seen anything like this. I feel like at the end that we're going to have to do an altar call. I feel like a preacher. All right. So, can you tell the cowboy hat isn't shiny? All right.
You forgot to polish it?
Yeah, I didn't polish it.
Oh, boy.
So, here's the deal. We're sitting out, and right now the weather, it said feels like temperature 101. So, if you see us sweating like hogs, you'll know why.
Yeah.
There's where you are. We keep looking down because that's our screen and my notes. If I didn't have notes, I wouldn't be able to make it.
Nah, it'd be horrible.
So, here's what we've got. Let me pull this up for you. I'm going to switch cameras real quick and go back here. So what we're going to talk about, and I don't want to waste your time, and I know you've waited a long time for this, but let me tell you how this came to fruition. Okay? And I know you've been getting my emails where I told you some of the story, so I'm not going to repeat the story. But what I am going to tell you is that I got such a response from vendors,
yep,
and vendors that haven't even started yet, people that are just thinking about vending, that I had to go to YouTube Live because most they would let me host on a webinar was 1,000 people.
Yep.
It was expensive as heck. And so I said, okay, I'm going to have to hook up Wirecast and then make it merge with YouTube. It was going to be... So I've been working on this. I've been excited as heck, and I've had, holy cow, hundreds of emails from you, and I'm excited to bring this to you. I have never in 9 years brought anything out like this. I've not talked about anything like this. I've been pitched stuff, Okay? I've been pitched stuff, but nothing like this. Nothing that will immediately, and you're going to hear more in a minute. So, well,
but
so
even,
there's a
even
tease.
With your experience, you were still a little hesitant when I told you.
Oh, I was hesitant as hell.
You had to.
I'm like gun shy. Yeah. I'm like, oh no, I'm not taking my eyes off the prize to get the shiny object. And it's why I named this the shiny,
shiny object.
Because Jason's the one that told me, you know, and I'm like, oh no, this was months ago, man. This is like 5 or 6 months ago.
6 months,
and I'm
yeah.
going, no, yeah, about 6 months.
About
and
six,
I'm like, yeah. oh no. Oh, that's great, Jason. More power to you, buddy. Hope you like Amway. You know, Shackley, selling Shackley, you know. So that's where I was. And so. It's been a rough one, but I'm going to show you, and Jason's going to show you. Jason has driven all the way here to be with me to
just
share this, which is cool because it's the first time I had to go visit him first. It's like first date stuff or something. I don't know. And I had to go visit him first, and then he finally came to me.
I had to get some time.
That's right. That's right. Let me move this up real quick. All right. So my promise... to you, I need to, I don't know why that moved. Yeah. If y'all see mistakes, just know that I struggled in third grade.
Well, they can write a complaint on a $50 bill and mail it in.
Yeah. Excellent idea. Yeah. Complaints about this broadcast, $50 bill, write it on it, send it in. It will get first attention.
Yes.
So here's my promise to you. I'm going to show you exactly. Okay, exactly. Let me turn this part off. That way it's not blocking your screen. How to use our unique system of catering to create a huge income. And I'm not talking a little income. Okay? With less time, without the learning curves, or having to trade. Now, we're going to go into this, Jason.
Big time.
Okay? To trade your time for dollars.
Yep.
$4. No, you know the Ghostbuster symbol?
Yeah.
That's what I want to do. It's like a shirt that says time
for dollars.
You know, the equal dollars and then the hashtag through it, you know, the hash through it. Because I don't like trading time for dollars. I've done it a lot, and most of my life I've done it. You know, I've sold cars, I've sold water purification systems, I've worked for Wendy's.
Yeah.
You know, and not as a manager. I was an official burger flipper trainee. Okay, trainee. So, how many of y'all listening right now work a regular job? How many have worked a regular job or are working a regular job?
Vending on the weekends.
Joy says, what's catering? Joy's funny because she's from out in Washington, so she critiques my hillbilly butt. 13 hours a day, Mark says. Adam says, teacher. Antonio says, don't forget satellites. Absolutely, Antonio. Satellite systems. I've sold satellites. I've sold, the water purification, I did good with it. Holy moly. But everything I was trading dollars. I've sold vacuums, Kirby vacuum cleaners. That's been about 25 years ago. I was like three. So, anyway, this is my promise to you for being here. And this gets better. Just bear with me just for a second, okay? If you stay till the end, this is my ethical bribe.
Yep.
All right? It's a bribe, but it's ethical. An unethical bribe is a whole different deal, and we'd have to go into politics to do that.
Yeah, this
but
is true.
I'm not a politician, so I have to do ethical bribes. So, here's my ethical bribe. I'm gonna give you... Never released. Jason helped me work on it last night. My never released catering on a budget blueprint. It's just a blueprint, but I'm going to give you the details today. Okay? Catering on a budget. How to get started with no money, basically.
Yeah.
Right? But I'm going to give you the blueprint so that when you're done today, you have that. Plus, I'm going to do a cash giveaway. Jason and I are going to do a cash giveaway today. Today. Okay? And this is to get you to stay. Why would we want that? Because why? This ain't a paid webinar.
Nope.
You could pay, then you could leave, and who would care?
Yeah.
You know, we got paid. This is not a paid webinar. It's 100% free, 100% free information. And you can take this information that we do today and apply it immediately into your life.
Yeah.
Immediately. Now, how many of you, and this won't apply to all of you, but I'd like to know real quick, how many of you are doing a job like, and what comes to mind is, because I got family members that do this, they truck drive, yeah. long haul
drivers,
right?
Yeah.
I've got a brother that does it, and he's watching his kids grow up on Skype.
Not seeing the wife, not seeing
he's
the
got,
kids.
Well, this brother has five kids watching them grow up on Skype. Yeah. So he gets to a pilot or a flying J, and he's Skyping his kids. Hey, kids, love you. Daddy loves you. Who's doing that? Who's doing that today?
Missing sporting events, missing school events.
Right.
Graduations, holidays, yeah.
And even if you're self-employed, you may be self-employed.
Try
How many of you are self-employed? I'm going to turn back on our cameras real quick so you can see us, okay? Because I want you to see this part. So you know we're here and we're live. Is how many of you right now are in a vending type business, food vending business, either work at a restaurant or do street food or do catering? Any of you do that? Could you post in the comments and let us know? Okay, I'm gonna go over there real quick. Just bear with me. Self-employed and drowning, Little Wing, brother. I know the feeling.
Yeah.
And you ain't alone.
Nope.
You ain't alone. So don't beat yourself up over it. Okay? Don't beat yourself up. Chris says FaceTime. He's watching his kids grow up on Chris says yep. on FaceTime. Danny says, as a chef, no time with family.
Yeah.
Who does that sound like?
Jose.
Chef Jose.
Yeah.
Chef Jose, same freaking deal, 70 hours a week.
Not seeing his kids, not seeing his wife.
Jim's doing street food. And street food's good. Don't get me wrong.
It's good.
Jason's been doing it for a while now, and you're going to get to hear more on that in just a minute. But I just wanted you to I wanted to find out from y'all what bugs you. You know, what gets you? Because I can promise you, you probably could poll 10 people. 8 of them have experienced something very similar,
yeah.
especially entrepreneur types. We are not the 9-to-5ers.
Nope.
We are the people who, we're either corporate, but we're management corporate, where we want to go more, or we are doing our own thing, truck driving, okay? We take long hauls, we never see our family, we have a pizza restaurant, and we never home because it requires 74 hours a week in work. I've wanted to change that forever. I've wanted to change that, and vending brought that a lot of that to me. Street food vending allowed me to control that.
Control the hours, be home a little more.
Right.
You know, if you need the day off, you take the day off.
But there's still been some struggles in that. Street food vending
holidays.
Still, yeah.
I do a lot of catering on the holidays.
And weekends.
Yeah, weekends are jammed.
Now, let me go to... this next one here, I'm going to turn this off real quick so I can show y'all. So here's what I need you to do. This is my house cleaning, Jason.
Yep. Got to do all this. Right. It's like the beginning of the movies.
It's like,
turn
yeah.
down.
And I know we've already been going, and I'm going to try to get through this fast, but please turn off your cell phones. If you want to get value from this,
yeah.
and I'm telling you, we're going to deliver value bombs today, like nuclear value bombs. Change your life bombs. It's why I did such a build-up to this. I wanted to change your life because I've gotten to see with several of my friends who I call guinea pigs, if you've been getting my emails, have changed their lives immediately with this. Okay? So we're going to give you a lot of information. And you may want a pen and paper handy. You may want to turn off the Facebooks and the Twitters and the Instagrams and the Snapchats.
That'll all be there when we get done.
Yeah, it'll still be there. That's a good point. It'll be there when you get done. So if you're an unsatisfied employee or entrepreneur and you want to change it all right now, as in literally change everything in a blink of an eye, and I'm going to give you a real, if you got my emails, you already heard part of the story, but I'm going to give you more of that here in just a minute, okay? This live webinar is going to change your whole perspective of vending. It'll change it all for you.
It's changed mine.
Yeah. Yeah. So here we go. All right. Let me go to the next page here. For those that don't know me, I know we have new people. I'll run through this quick. Okay. I know some of you have heard me, you know, tell my story for nine years. Okay. But PhD from the School of Trial and Error. You could say the School of Hard Knocks if you wanted, but everybody has hard knocks. I just went with something different, Trial and Error. Okay. Spent the last 9 years I have as a vendor caterer. And even though I don't vend full time anymore, I probably touch a card about as much as a full-time vendor.
Yeah.
Because I still do training. Yeah. I still go see vendors. I still do like live web chats, interviews with vendors so that I can help them if they need a consult. I'm active in it. And then about 3 to 4 times a year, I do a charity event, depending on if the fire department needs to raise money or the volunteer fire department or the we here, you know, in our town, our hometown, we have the largest children's home. It's a orphanage in the eastern United States, the largest one. So we do some fundraising, we do something, right? So I've also been, and this is tooting my horn, right? Toot. Best-selling author of course book Hot Dog Saved My Life, number one course book for street food vending in the world now. And as a publisher and editor for the world's largest food vending and training site, and y'all probably know it, learnhotdogs.com, okay? And I've been doing that for about 8 years now, the Learn Hot Dogs part, learnhotdogs.com. Now, I started vending on the side of the road with a piece of crap cart in 2007 and went out on to have 22 carts my first year, within 12 months, and then I began teaching others. Now, I still ran carts, but I was just putting up YouTube videos. I called that teaching, okay? And with now over 25,000 people that were directly affected by my training, successful vendors in countries all over the world. Now, I'm proud of that. And so, you know, if we were real rich and we were doing a fancy webinar, I'd have like an announcer say this. And now is Ben Wilson, 25,000 vendors he's personally trained. You know, it'd sound really sexy. I went from food stamps, living in a borrowed home, and with five of our 10 kids, to making over $7,000 a month my very first month with from a little tiny town to East Tennessee, right? Because a lot of people go, "Oh, you got to have a big town,
big city.
You got to be." Nope. I took a cart into a town that had never seen a freaking cart, and they went, "What is that?" I had more people pulling over, not because they knew what it was, because what is that weird, crazy, shiny object on the side of the road blowing out steam? Looks like it's on fire. So. I started, you know, I was bankrupt is the bottom line. I not in just a general sense. I actually filed bankruptcy and on food stamps and people helping pay my bills. And I heard a story and I said, you know what? I think I can do what he did. This guy saved his family's home with a hot dog cart. I think it was in New Mexico. And I read it online and I was like, oh, well, if he can do that, I can do that. I mean, how hard is it to boil a hot dog kind of deal? And so I jumped right in and my life has been never been the same. As they say, it's, you know, it's history, but been amazing. Now I want to introduce you real quick. I'm going to put this back on real quick so you can see us. I want to introduce you real quick, Jason Brown, if you don't know him. Jason the Love Brown. Because he's got Love Food Truck Company, and he's got some other stuff, and I'm going to let him share that with you real quick. I'm going to pull this up for him so you can see. We got notes. We're fancy. All right? So here's Jason Brown.
Well, guys, some of you know me, some of you don't. So for the ones that don't, I'm Jason Brown. I started in mobile food vending in 2008 with Beatrice's Inferno. It was the East Coast first mobile wood-fired catering unit. And I was a canine officer at that time. And shortly, right after we started that, I got hurt. So it changed everything. And right before canine, I was in the fire department, swapped over to canine and working. We started the wood-fired pizza, and once this accident happened, it changed my life.
Now, you were the first wood-fired pizza.
Mobile wood-fired pizza.
On the East Coast.
Yeah, on the Eastern Seaboard, yeah.
That's a long area, because it goes from what, Miami, or the Keys, all the way up to
Maine.
Maine.
Yeah, the next closest was Texas.
Wow.
So, that was Beatrice's Inferno. After Beatrice's Inferno, we started Love Hot Dog Company.
All right.
After Love Hot Dog Company was Love Food Truck Company. In between there was the Lemonade Brothers.
Which was your sons?
The boys. Right. They were 6 and 8. We did the Conspiracy Food Truck Crew, which is basically a consortium of trucks that I put together, and we basically provide trucks for business parks and food rotations, colleges, things like that.
Now, Jason, I'd love for you to, you say a consortium, you know, and, or I hope I pronounced that right. Consortium.
Consortium. Yeah.
Consortium.
It works.
Okay. I don't know the word, but I know what it means. Right. But I want you to, because this directly ties to this, because we're talking about catering, but extreme catering, you created a way to do gigs without using you.
Yeah.
And to make money.
So what I did was, once we got busy, if I couldn't do a job, the next question from was, well, who can you recommend? Well, I had some bad ones, I had some good ones, and I had to start weeding the bad ones out. I had to know that if I told you to call this guy, he was going to be fair price, good food, on time, clean up. Treat your people right. So then once I started finding them, we just started keeping the work amongst us, and then we started booking jobs where we'd take over a whole fair or a whole event. It was just our trucks from the Conspiracy Crew. And this way, the event promoters knew they're getting a truck that's licensed, insured, staffed right, clean, good menu, good food. And it made a huge difference, you know, because now I'm subbing these jobs out and charging for it.
Right,
so even though
right.
I couldn't do the job, I'm still making a little money off of it. So that's kind of the Conspiracy Food Truck.
And you can take that and go somewhere with it.
Oh, yeah.
He just gave you some valuable information, and we have a vendor right now
just
who's
started
doing it.
Just started doing it. Yep. You got to get going and do it before somebody else does in your area. So this is something, you know.
Because once you build the credibility and that you're accountable, they'd much rather have a variety of food trucks that they can use, but one person to deal with instead
of
dealing with this person, that person, that person, that person, and problems, and oh, they didn't show up.
Yep.
They can call Jason and go, hey, the taco guy's not here yet. Jason gets on the horn. Hey, where's Taco Dude? Okay, Taco Dude's late from a catering gig. I'm going to send over the pizza dude or my backup Taco Dude.
Yep. I always have a backup to my backups. And
it's called redundancy.
Yep. Fail safe. So, kind of what brought me to street food vending, I got run over by a car. So, 19 surgeries later, here we are. And, you know, that's basically what, in a nutshell, brought me to street food vending. And, you know, it's been good to me. But, again, always looking for that thing to change, save money, make more money. It's kind of what brought us here.
6 of those surgeries, though, I want y'all to know were... sex change operation.
Yep.
So real truck wreck, or the person running over him. No, he had a DW, somebody driving in under the influence, hit him, and 19 surgeries for real.
Yep.
And it needed to change something. Couldn't really go do canine cop stuff. Because that's what you did. You canine cop.
Yeah.
He doesn't like the word cop, even though we were both cops.
Canine handler.
Yeah. So anyway. I'm gonna move on here. Let me do this real quick. All right, so let's move on with this. I know you're waiting, you're dying to know what we got in store. Okay? I want you to imagine something though. I want you to imagine what your life will be like when, okay, you have more income than is required and more free time than you've ever dreamed of. And I kid you not, we've tested this. You never have to worry about trading time for dollars again. Now, do you want to touch on that subject just a little bit? Trading time for dollars, what is that?
Well, I'm missing my kid's school function because I'm working. So I'm trading my time and my family's time for dollars to pay the bills.
Right.
takes me out of the equation. I'm not there.
Now, you could extrapolate it all out. Any exchange for money is a time value. Yeah. But there's people like Bill Gates, let's say. If he doesn't work today, he still makes money.
Yes.
So what we're going to show you is how to Bill Gates it.
Yeah.
Not, I ain't talking about get rich quick scheme. I'm not talking about, oh, you're a billionaire overnight. I'm not talking about that. What I'm talking about is the fact, and Jason's proof, and we have some others too, okay, that have tested this and are doing it. You've been testing it the longest because you're the one that introduced me, okay? And you're able to stay home if you want, send somebody out for $50, and not do the you're not trading time for dollars now.
No. Nope.
So you could literally be on Facebook checking out the latest thing, the latest funny meme with a cat.
Yep.
And holy moly. Okay, so that's what I'm talking about. What will your life be like when you're able to work when you want, how you want, and make what you want? And when I say make what you want, don't be ridiculous with this. Don't take this to the nth degree and go, can I be a billionaire? Well, sure you can. Probably could be an astronaut quicker, but yes, you can be a billionaire. I mean, I believe people can. I just
put your mind to it.
Yeah, I think there's a lot of things that have to fall into place. But are we? If you're truthful about this, what you're after is freedom. Freedom, meaning I'm not trading time for dollars, and I can go home when I want. I'm in control of my own life. That's freedom to me.
Being able to see your kids, being able to see your wife, your family.
Or not miss a family reunion.
Yeah.
Or not miss at a recital.
Yep. Or soccer game.
Right.
Whatever.
Or not have to figure out which one am I going to pay this month, my electric bill or my car payment.
Yeah.
And looking at what the extra fee is if you're late for 6 days. How about when you know how to make money hands off? And I'm talking hands off. Okay. Take a few phone calls and make over $2,000 weekly. Literally, we're going to show you today how you can take phone calls, pick the ones you want, no joke,
qualified
candidates. And just give them a little hint, how many today?
An hour ago, we were up to about 12, 13.
Okay, so that's 12, 13 calls for people wanting to give you money.
Yeah.
Okay, so here we go. Let me move this on. Now, let me tell you, results and proof. Jason, I'll let you tell your own just a little bit about what you've done with this so far as far as the catering part. Just what is possible?
Well,
based on your...
2 to 3 jobs a day. Many different catering styles, I'll say.
Okay.
Again, I can, you know, do we want to go into how it saves or?
Well, no, we're going to get into that in a minute, but I wanted you to be proof. You've been doing this how long?
6 months.
6 months. Okay. And now can you, if you wanted to, you can do 3 to 4 jobs a day or you can
I like 2 to 3. I don't want to go past 3 because it's just,
and do you
I
have
like
to,
being rushed.
Do you have to physically do all that?
No.
If you don't want to.
Nope. And you witnessed that.
Yeah, I did. Multiple times.
Yeah.
Okay. This is what sold me. Okay. So then if y'all have been getting my emails, I told you about Mr. Harris. He's got more business than he knows what to do with, and he's one of my guinea pigs out of Florida.
Yep.
Okay. And then my dad's church friend, let me tell you this real quick. This is hilarious.
Yeah.
My dad's church friend, I was telling my dad, I was excited about this. So I'm calling my dad. I'm like, I'm at the hotel in Pennsylvania. And I'm like, Dad, you got to, man, it's so cool, Dad. The way he's doing this, it's not just, oh, he's got this and he's doing this. It's how he's doing it and what he's been able to do with it. And other people are doing it and we're testing it, Dad. This is so cool. And my dad's like, sounds pretty good. I hope you do good with it, son. Sounds good. You know, just kind of supportive, but you could tell like he didn't ask me any questions about it.
Wasn't
you could
sure.
tell there was no interest really. Well, then he calls me up all excited because his buddy at church, he told his buddy at church, okay, about it. His buddy gets, go. He wants in, yeah. Right? He wants in. Oh, I want in. I want to do this. I got to do it, right? Yeah. How do you do it, Ben? So I tell his buddy, okay, about his age, probably 70-ish. And so I tell him about it. Well, he doesn't even want the business. He just wants, now check this out. He doesn't want to know the business.
He just wanted it for home.
He just wanted it for home. He just said, I just want to, that's cool as crap. I could use that for family reunions and stuff. Well, his wife took a picture.
A little upset.
Huh?
Yeah,
a little upset. Took a picture, posted on Facebook, and said, look what my husband bought, another contraption for the yard, basically. Yeah. And he booked 2 gigs.
Off that email.
Off that freaking Facebook post. And then got a 3rd gig off his 1st gig while he's there. And I watched that happen in person with you.
Yeah.
So, well, more than once, because we recorded one. Yeah. The lady that come up, okay? Yeah. So we're going to tell you more about that. So here's the other thing. This is all provable without spending any of your money. So you can actually do this without spending any of your money. You can test it. And we're going to show you how to do that too.
Yep. What else can you do in test market without buying?
You got to spend money.
Yeah, got to spend money to make money, but...
But this is, you don't.
Nope.
So we've just proven that a false thing. You got to spend money to make money.
Nope.
No, you can actually test this out before you spend a dime and go, is this going to work for me? Is it going to work in my area? I don't know if I trust Ben and Jason. I don't know if I trust Mr. Harris. I don't know if I trust Ben's dad's church friend.
Yep.
He could not even be real. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying, though, right?
Yeah,
so, because I'd be that way.
Yeah.
I mean, my tag on my truck says skeptic.
Skeptic. Yeah. So,
took
me a little while to get you on board.
Oh, yeah. Because I'm skeptical as hell. So, now here's the deal. I got to tell this to CYA.
Yep.
Okay. We got to say this. I walked through the system. Let me turn this off so you can see the whole thing. Okay. I'm going to walk you through the system that we're using to get real results, fantastic results, amazing results, and have been for 6 months. Please understand that these results, though, are not typical because the average person who attends any training live doesn't get any results, zero results, because just going to a training doesn't change anything.
Nope.
You just
gotta
you learn something. You got to apply the information.
Yep.
It's like somebody saying, oh, the stock market's up. If you put 500 right now in what's-a-muth-a-doodle, you can make this much money. Well, now you know the information, but if you don't do it,
you
ain't getting
anything.
Jack squat. However, I'm happy to share all this with you for free. Jason's here to share this for free. This is not for get-rich-quick people.
Nope.
But I'll give you a little hint. Over $2,000 a week, you can do easily with about how many hours a week, roughly, realistically? Worst case scenario?
8 to 10.
8 to 10?
Yeah, maybe 12 on the outside.
Okay. How would you like to trade 8 to 12 hours of your week?
And that's not all hard labor either. I mean, that's phone calls, emails.
Right.
You know.
What a beautiful thing. That's why I'm so excited about this. Here's what we're going to cover, right? We're going to cover how the highest income earning vendors work less than the average vendor and what we have proven to be the fastest way to achieve that. Okay. We're going to also cover how to build up gigs and have money in hand before you're even ready to begin. Okay. That was the testing thing. And how to make your business competition free. In fact, you won't even know what competition is.
Nope.
That's the other thing that's brilliant. Brilliant. Okay. So, I know you're excited and you're probably going, Ben, hurry up, get on with it, get on with it, get on with it. But I got to tell you this stuff. We've had an attorney, his name's David Webb.
Huh?
And our attorney, every time I do a live training, which is usually once a year, roughly, and usually it's over something like something. I've never had anything this exciting. So he'll tell me, you got to do the CYA, got to do the CYA. So secret one, how the highest income earning vendors work less than the average vendor and what we have proven to be the fastest way to achieve that, okay? So here's the deal. How to make a huge income with catering. Now, I've been preaching catering for how long, Jason?
Oh, years.
Yeah.
Heavy for three.
Almost 4 years,
yep.
But heavy for three.
Closer to four.
Yeah. I'm sorry, I was taking a sip of my drink. Most entrepreneurs think the only way to make lots of money is to be in a big city.
It's not true.
Like for catering.
Yeah, not true. You've been to my house.
Now, I want you to get in the mindset of catering, but I want you to take out of your mindset anything that you've heard or learned before, except what has been on the show and stuff. But I'm talking about what you think is a typical catering. Yeah. When I think of catering, just the average person, I think, oh, that's my local restaurant. Like Outback Steakhouse says, we cater. Yeah. I've seen it at KFC. We cater. Let us lunch. Cater your next party. Ugh. Taco Bell.
Ooh.
Dairy Queen. Now, all of it's doable, I guess. Yeah. I mean, they could bring you some melty ice creams, I guess, from Dairy Queen. But they do make good chicken gravy, though, for your chicken dippers. So, anyway, it's a misnomer. Yeah. It's a misnomer. We're going to show you a new way to do this. Actually, you can make more money as a roasting nomad. Now, you probably don't never heard that.
Ding, 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 ding.
Ding, 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 ding. That's your first hint, all right? Your first hint. You want to be a roasting nomad? And it's really kind of deceiving because roast, well, you could, when catering, you can grill, you can roast, you can steam, you can boil, you can bake, you can do whatever, right? So, but roasting nomad. Kind of playing off the word roaming nomad, right? In 1 week than you can in a month with a normal vending site. What do I mean by all that? You ready? Average gig.
2 hours of service, about a half hour to 40 minutes of prep.
Okay. So there about you go. Average gig.
30 minutes of cleanup max.
All right. 3 hours of work. Average gig. And do you have to actually do any of that stuff if you don't want to?
Nope.
And can you still make
money?
Still make the profit?
Sure.
Okay. No stock investment. The customer pays up front, period, because you're supposed to be getting what?
30% up front.
There you go.
They book the jobs, 30% up front.
And what does 30% cover usually?
Food cost.
And a little more.
Ding, 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 ding.
Another tip. Hope you're writing down. Take notes, because I kid you not, take notes.
Should we be writing that on the board?
I can do
that. Write that one on the board?
Yeah. All I'm going to write it on the board. Y'all can't see me right now. I'm going to...
So, should we go red?
I'm going to put up the camera real quick. Are you going to write it? Oh, okay.
You're on that side.
Here, you can tell we're prepared. We're like professionals. We're out on my deck. Let me put this up real quick for you so you can see us. All right, so...
So, the average gig, 3 hours.
3 hours, average gig.
And that's 2 hours of service time, and we'll call it an hour split between prep and cleanup. And again, I don't have to do it. I can pay somebody.
Right.
And a good pay. I mean, 15 to 20 bucks an hour.
Hey, can you tell, are you a redneck? You got this hat, this shirt, in shorts, and barefooted. So what was the other thing?
So the average gig's 3 hours. Okay, that includes a two-hour service time. We'll call it an hour prep and cleanup.
All right.
After that, we covered no stock investment because the customer's paying up front, 30% up front, and that needs to be when they book the gig. So are we 2 weeks out or a month out? But
now, no stock investments because you collected
30% up front.
Up front.
So that covers my food cost. So now I really have no out-of-pocket cost. Okay, so 30% is the cost of my goods.
Zero out of pocket.
Yep. So, and it pays me the same as the owner, whether I'm paying Ben to go out and actually do the job.
Or you do it.
Or I do it. So, if I'm working during the week and the job comes up, I'm paying somebody to go. And we're paying, I'm between 15 and 20 bucks an hour for my people.
But you get good people that way.
Well, I get good people that way. So that's another tip. You got to pay good to get good, okay? So now we've got these guys going out, or I'm going out and doing the job, and I'm still making money. Whether I pay somebody to go or whether I go and do it,
right?
I'm still making money. So, $2,400 a week profit.
None of your time.
None of my time.
And then you said $2,400 average?
I'd say average weekly profit.
$2,400 weekly. Now, tell me this real quick, and then we're gonna switch over so we can see what they're saying. Okay, how many of you would love to make $2,400 a week and work how many hours a week?
Well, I call it 12. Let's say 12 to be modest. Yeah.
Okay.
And then also, you know, the biggest thing is,
I know the board's tiny. I know it
yeah,
is.
Yeah, we'll have to.
You're gonna get show notes, so don't worry.
Yep. And again, the other thing is we're immediately picking.
Hold on now. I want to see some people. How many of you would make? Oh, Bob says he would. There you go. 220 hours sounds great to me. That would solve my financial struggle. Yep. Don says, Don, I am with you 100%, brother. Yep. It does, and it will, I promise. I promise it will. It works.
Yeah. Well, how about immediately being able to pick and choose the most profitable gig? That's huge.
Oh.
That's huge.
That is huge. So you can pick the gigs you want, and you've got... Okay, here's an example real quick. Jason, I know for a fact, because he woke up this morning. We've sat outside at 6:30 this morning, drank a cup of coffee together, and he started getting messages.
Ding, ding,
ding, ding, ding, ding, ding. Calls. Yep. People wanting to book gigs. Now, Jason's in a huge metropolis of a town of 9,400 people. Yeah. Okay? But he's done this right.
I think my town has one more light than yours.
Yeah, one more light.
One more. So I would call it a metropolis.
Right. So he's in this town, and
Mennonite Mile.
Yeah, it's a Mennonite area, and you are turning down work, yeah, picking only the ones you want to do,
and subbing out the others to other trucks.
And this is instantly, folks. I'm telling you, I've done this. We've tested this with five different people, in five different states, and no one didn't make money within the first 72 hours of doing what we say.
Yeah. Well, we're going to tell them how to test it.
Yeah.
Try it without buying.
And you can try it without spending any money.
Yep.
That's
test
the cool
market
part. What else can you do like that?
Nothing.
Like they can sell you a backhoe and tell you can be a ditch digger. But you got to, in order to know if you're going to make money with that
ditch. Got to buy that hoe.
You got to buy the hoe.
Yep.
That ruined my first two marriages. And I just rented the hoes. I didn't even buy them.
Rent to own.
Rent to own. So, now let me take you up to here. Let me show you. Let me turn this off so you could see the screen. All right. Let me show you how to build up gigs and have money in hand before you even are ready to begin.
Yep.
Okay. Can you give them some examples of this real quick?
Well, we can use
this
your dad's
is secret
buddy.
Number two.
We can use your dad's buddy. I mean,
but he did it by accident.
That was by accident, but. So do we let them know how we do this? We're going to tell them how to test market it here? Or?
Yeah, tell them, give them the basic of how to test market this, because that's what I've promised.
We're going to use social media.
That's the best way.
Yeah, best way. Okay, and that includes Craigslist, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram.
And we're going to tell you, we'll tell you what to say, but you can actually test it.
Yep, so you're going to put this out there and let them know what this
that
is.
That you offer catering. Yeah, but let's use a different thing.
All right.
Let's use this. Okay, let's use you cater pasta.
Yep.
Use pasta right now with
okay, so
catering.
We
you
don't give it totally
that
away. All
right. Right.
So the way I would go about it, I'd put out that we're available for pasta catering.
Right.
Here's our number. Here's our site. Give us a call. Who needs catering? You need it at the office. You got a graduation party. You got an employee appreciation. Do you have a customer appreciation? We're available. Here's what we can do. I'll list the menu out. Boom. And I'll send that out.
Okay.
Once that hits, you start getting responses.
But what do you think, could you honestly say this, that on one gig, that you will end up getting at least one gig in the next 3 months
off of that gig? Oh, yeah. Always. And that's a matter of having the business cards, the rack cards, and doing a good job, and over-delivering.
Okay.
You got to over-deliver.
Which we're going to talk a little more on.
We're going to cover that later, yeah.
So, how to have more gigs than you even want or need, and have them immediately, okay? And that is by, well, one is over-delivering on your first
yes
gig. Yep. Number two is what Jason just explained, marketing. Mm-hmm. Marketing will, and you can do this for free.
Yeah. You don't
and
need
especially
a marketing company
if you do it humbly.
Yep.
If you don't do this, you don't need, you don't have in skip back and stuff, billboards or nothing,
nah,
do you? Right?
Nope.
Do you have any advertising at all that cost you any money?
Do I do any? No.
No, right now.
No.
Do you have any ads?
Nope.
And you got how many calls today?
12 or 13?
12 or 13 freaking calls to do jobs in a town of 9,400.
Yeah.
What does that say? I'm telling you, we have struck gold, and that's why I built this up. Yep. I wanted you here, and I wanted to share this because it makes me happy that I'm going to change lives. And I've already changed a family member's life.
Yep.
Just by this, because they were struggling anyway, and I figured they'd make a great guinea pig, because they weren't even in vending.
Nope.
They had never done vending.
It's all new to them. It was by accident.
So, most unsatisfied entrepreneurs think it will take a long time to build up this business.
Nah.
And I get that fear of, oh, it takes a while to build it up. How long will it take them if they do exactly what we say, without spending money? Will it take them to get the first gig in an average town of, let's say, 10,000 people?
I'd say you can get it before you even have...
before you have even the food, or even know where to get the food.
Yeah. And that's not a problem. You don't need to be afraid of that. You just might have to tell them, well, hey, Ben, I'm sorry, I'm not available
until the third
week of September.
Right.
It's not a bad thing to get a response, and I don't want you to be afraid of that when you put this out there. You don't want to go, oh, Ben, I can't put this out there because what if somebody wants me to do the job? Well, that's a good thing. We just tell them, hey, Ben, I'm sorry, I'm not available the second week of September. So it's not a bad thing, and don't be afraid of it.
Right. Actually, let me show you how to build up gigs and have money in hand before you're even ready to begin. Now, we did this because, my dad's church buddy, he actually... he didn't know what to do.
Yeah,
that's why he called me. He was panicked, and he's going, I don't know what to do this. And this is how he talks. I don't know what to do this stuff. I just don't. Do I make them sign something or what? And I said, you need to collect about 30% down. What'd you quote him? I ain't quoted him yet. He said he'd pay me, and I said, well, let's figure out a price.
Yep.
And let's, what are you doing? What are you delivering? And let's figure out a price. And he went, oh. And he was on board. The light bulb came on.
Yeah, the light bulb came on. You love that moment.
Yeah.
Love when they get it.
And y'all will see. So anyway, I'm gonna roll down a screen here real quick. So we just talked about pre-marketing tests.
Yep, doing a test. No money down. No commitment to buying. Give it a test.
Right.
How to have a deposit and never dip into your own pocket. We sort of covered that.
Yeah.
So we're talking standard is 30%. And that covers your food costs. This way you're
But we have one guy that's doing 100%.
Yes. Yeah, some guys will do it.
He's scared to death. He's not going to get paid, so 100% up front.
I do final payment 2 weeks out.
2 weeks before the gig.
Before the event, I get final payment.
Okay.
So some of my repeat customers, I'll let them pay that day because they can... Even though they're paying 2 weeks out, we send them the bill, they can add on a gratuity. But you're more likely to see it if you're handing them the phone or the iPad to finish up the sale. But yes, I get paid 2 weeks out.
Now, on this, how do you handle the requests? Like I put here in the notes, before you even are ready to start, like you mentioned just a minute ago, by saying... because you're test marketing and you haven't spent any money and you get somebody who goes, I need you Saturday. Can you be here Saturday? What would you say to Mr. Jones who calls you up and says, hey, I need you to bring, can you be here Saturday? What do you say if you haven't, you're just doing your test marketing?
Do they have some type of vending cart or nothing?
If they have a vending cart, they could go ahead and get...
Well, I'm not available with this, but I can do that.
Right.
So you could do the job with hot dogs and sausage.
But what if you had nothing? You're in the testing phase.
Well,
would you just put them off like you said?
Me, I put the first one off. But you could go and cater with some disposable hotel pans and things of that nature and do the job and do a drop-off catering, basically, depending what menu they're looking for.
And we already have vendors doing that.
Yeah,
we have some vendors doing that right now with no equipment, no nothing.
And they're
catering.
Some catering jobs.
Yeah. Now, just so you know... I'm going to touch on this real quick, is in the United States, catering is easier than hot dog vending as far as red tape and licensing.
Yes.
I'm going to go into that in a little bit.
Yep, we're going to cover it.
But it is easier. it's easier to cater in some states. You don't even have to have a commissary.
Cater out of your house.
But even if you have to have a commissary, if you've followed us, you know how to get it, but we're going to teach you as well. Still less red tape. Still less red tape. Still less of everything. And if you're buying from a licensed facility, okay, let's say you're buying, like you buy your salads from a licensed facility, right?
Yeah, made. Yeah.
So he's not at home or at his commissary making salads. He buys them the way he wants them.
And when we say salads, we're not talking about a lettuce salad. We're talking about
a nice,
you know, potato salad, coleslaw, antipasta, roasted corn salad, macaroni salad, all things like that. Quinoa salad, gourmet stuff. I don't waste my time making them anymore. We used to do that. I'm better spent answering emails or things like that. So I have my salads made.
Yeah, you've come a freaking long ways in 6 months with this.
Yep.
And you're going to find out more about this here in a little bit, and it's going to be mind-blowing. So if you're going, oh, this is just another – Ben's just going on another rant about catering.
No, I kind of am ranting about catering,
but I'm going to show you a way to flip this on its head and blow your noodle today, okay?
We told him it was a Swiss Army knife, right?
It's the Swiss Army knife of catering.
Yeah.
Because and that was your term, which I loved.
Because it does multiple things. This isn't just a one-trick pony.
No.
Okay. This is incredible. This is catering on many different levels, many different menus.
Yeah, unlimited. It's limited by what you feel like you want to do and your imagination.
Yeah.
It's kind of like, how do you want to get to success now? The only thing standing in your way is air and opportunity.
Yep.
That's it.
Yeah.
So, secret three, you will make the competition irrelevant by implementing a few simple strategies, and I'm going to go through those with you. We're going to show you how. Let me turn this off again real quick so that's out of the way so you can read. We're going to destroy the competition while being the most expensive.
Yep.
And you're going, what?
People, you guys thought I was crazy.
Can we just give them the one, just the one recently that you did that even one of our vendors didn't believe
me. I just sent them
and we sent a copy.
Snapchat.
You sent a
snapshot of the bill and showed him off of Square.
Right.
Because it was during a show and he privately messaged me and said, come on, you know, you couldn't make that. There's no way. You're full of it, basically.
Right.
So I sent him a screenshot because I had just
roughly
gotten
roughly what was that?
It came out almost $40 a head or $43-something a head, I think.
Okay, now I want you to think about that. That is a higher end.
Yeah, that's definitely higher end.
But tell me this. Could you make a profit, barbecue, seafood, at 18, 12?
Yeah.
What about $12 a head? $15
a head? You could do it at 12, 15. I mean, I think you need to be somewhere in the 18 to 24 a head.
Okay, so let's say, and some people do, we have two right now that are doing about, well, the lowest one's $12.99 a head. Yep. Okay, on a basic meal.
Yeah.
Right? And $12.99 a head, 50 head minimum. No, he's actually got a 60 head minimum.
Yeah.
Okay? Which doesn't mean that they got to get 20 extra people to come if they only have 40.
They're
paying for 60.
Yeah,
and they can have the leftovers.
Yep.
Here you go.
I mean, sometimes I don't even tell them a per head price. I tell them this is the price for the job.
Right. They'll do the math usually.
Yeah.
If they've done it before.
Most of them won't.
They won't?
No, most of them I found don't even.
So if they won't do the math, then but to me, I would do the math. Like, yeah. I'd be like, okay, Jason just told me $700 for my party. I want to make sure how much is that per head, and I divide
it. And they divide it.
And I go, okay, well, that's worth it, because if I went to, how much does it cost to Golden Corral right now?
Taking everybody out, you're talking, for an adult, probably 20, 22.
I think me and my wife just ate on the way back from your place. And it was 28 a head.
Yeah.
It was 28 a head.
And your son, he was what, 18 or something?
He was 18, and he's 15 years old, so they gave him a discount of $10.
Yeah. And that was basically one plate.
Right.
So.
I'm going to put this back on so y'all can see real quick. Let's see.
See our ugly mugs.
Yeah, now you can see our ugly mugs. Let's see. Okay, so... destroying the competition by being the most, it's not like you intentionally are the most expensive, but while you're the most expensive, you're creating the most value and competition. Let me give you an example of competition real quick. Competition. Do you think Apple has competition?
Oh yeah.
No, but in the here's how I see Apple. No competition to me. They got Samsung and everybody trying, Nokia and all of them
trying to catch them.
They're all trying to imitate this guy, Apple, right? They all try to get there. So does Apple really have competition? Because every year they're coming out with new stuff. And they're creating more value than anyone else.
Everybody's playing catch up.
Right. That who's competing? The people below Apple.
Below are competing, yeah.
Samsung, Nokia,
they're all competing.
Sony, they're all competing for your business, and they're competing with each other while Apple says, yeah, our iPhones, you're going to need to mortgage a second mortgage on your house.
Yeah. True.
And so they're the most expensive. But we've tested this even, because I promise you, y'all know me, if you've been with me, I will not bring you something that, one, I haven't done or tested. Okay, or and. It's a and, not and or. It's both.
Yeah.
I've done and tested, okay? And I'm not going to bring you something that I'm not sure will change anything. So it's why for the last 9 years, I've told you about two things. I told you about ice cream vending and lemonade vending.
Yep.
That's it. In 9 years. That's
add-ons.
It.
And they were just add-ons.
They were just add-ons to what you
to
were
what
doing.
You're already doing. Yeah.
I'm fixing to show you something that's not really an add-on that you, if you haven't even started, you could do alone and make plenty of money.
Yep.
Okay? And if you already have a cart or a trailer or a food truck,
this is a great add-on.
This will probably make more.
Yep.
Just to be honest, with less time.
Less time.
It definitely will make more with less time.
Yeah.
That's what I'll tell you.
Oh,
it's
yeah.
going to make more with less time of your time. And with less of an investment.
True.
This isn't real. So actually, you will make the competition irrelevant by implementing a few simple strategies. We just covered some of those, but one of them was the price. A couple of them is over-delivering.
Yes.
Okay? Give them an example of over-delivery.
Well, party I just did Saturday and Sunday, both of them.
Mm-hmm.
One, they didn't order a veggie option. I brought two.
So they didn't order a vegetable option, yep. But you brought two.
I brought veggie burgers, and I brought our sweet chili lime hummus with the whole grain pita chip on sea salt. And I did that because you know there's always somebody.
You make that sound sexy. You know, you could have just said pita and chips.
Oh, no. Or whole grain pita chips with sea salt, man.
Yeah, but you also said, what was the hummus?
Sweet chili lime hummus.
You could have said chips and hummus.
No.
You're like, oh, with sea salt drizzled with olive oil.
Yeah,
Slowly roasted over a fire in Ireland.
You have to. I mean, you got to, you know, it's all about the wording on your product. I mean, you know, what sounds better, our brisket sandwich or our 13-hour slow-roasted brisket over hickory, apple, and cherry wood with caramelized onions and your choice of sauce.
We may have to go because now I'm hungry.
Now I'm hungry.
Right.
We haven't eaten yet. But the other party, the over-delivering was, it was a gentleman who is president of a bank a couple towns over from me. It was his granddaughter's party. Well, same thing. Didn't bring a veggie option. So I brought a veggie option, and knowing there was going to be kids there, I brought lemonade. I only did 16 ounces, but I did all the cool colors for kids.
Right.
So purple, blue, pink, yellow, green. Well, the kids just went nuts. They didn't care what the flavor was. They just wanted their color. I also, on that one, delivered pulled pork. Well, the adults went nuts. And the guy's like, well, I didn't have that. What's this going to cost me? I said, no, this is what we do. I knew you were going to need a vegetarian option. I knew the kids would dig the lemonade. And the pulled pork.
The lemonade was brilliant.
Oh, yeah. Well,
it was a kid's party.
Oh, yeah. They had a big blow-up moon house with, you know, water on the end and rock climbing on this end, and it was crazy.
Now, these are people, the kind of people that will automatically, they'll be your best billboards.
Oh, yeah.
And they'll advertise for you. It's incredible.
With this guy being the president of a bank, right out of that party, we've already received 3 calls. That was Sunday. Plus, we're going to do more for the bank. So, the over-delivering is... You know, and I'm not saying double your food cost. I'm saying if Ben didn't order a vegetarian option, I take one anyway. Because you know there's going to be somebody at the party. Lemonade was a simple add-on for the kids. I don't know. I might have made 30, 40 cups of lemonade in 16 ounces.
Right.
So cut that in half for my price for the normal 32s. Again, not going to break my bank, but we went over and above for this customer. So he was thrilled.
But it ends up, and they want you back next year. They're like pre-booking you.
Oh, yeah. Well, he's booking us for some stuff at the bank. Some of his friends are booking us. I mean, you know.
Booked up.
Oh, God, yeah. It's just over-delivering.
Well, 12 to 13 just today requests that he hadn't even returned yet.
No.
So it's a matter of not – it's not a matter of how much business you're going to get. It's which business you want.
Yeah.
That's what it comes down to. Yeah. I was with Jason when he turned down – and basically blew one off that was just being an ass, is the only way I could put it. Just being an ass. And they kept trying to dick her, and Jason's like, hey, I think the best thing for you to do is find another company. There's a bunch on Google.
Yep.
and just moved on. What a great feeling. You pick when you want work, where you work, and how much money
and
you
want
to make.
Work for.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's brilliant. And then the beauty of this is, too, because I watched you do this, because of the three deals going at one time, and you've got – you just hire people, but you pay them good. You've trained them good, and they go do it. And they clean up.
Yeah.
So it's like you just made money, didn't have to be there.
Nope. Let them go out and do it.
And they represented you well.
Yeah.
So beautiful. Okay, so we covered that. Let's move on. I'm gonna run over here to the comments real quick, because we got comments. Cheryl says, what is she goes, what's so shiny? We haven't told her yet.
Me.
Oh yeah,
I'm shiny, Cheryl.
Jason's shiny. No, we got something coming for you. All right. I know you're going, oh my gosh, we've been on this for an hour now. We've been at this an hour. Okay?
So and they're getting rammy.
Yeah, well, yeah, it's like, oh man. But you think about this. How much does it cost to go to the average college?
Whew. A lot, ask me. My money and my daughter go.
Right. Mine, I've had four daughters go to college. Four. Okay. And so you go, how much is college? Let's say you went community college first and then on to a four-year university for the last 2 years. You're still going to be in the 60-80 range if you got a good deal and you were a resident of the state.
Loans
and student
loan, yep.
Student grants or whatever, right? And you go, what's the value coming out? Well, yeah, they're more educated, and they know how to like recite Plato or Socrates, but what value do they bring to the world in money? Can they go support themselves immediately? I have two daughters out of college, one with two master's degrees, can't get a job.
No.
Some say she's overqualified.
Yep.
And some say, oh, we can pay you, it's $23,000 a year.
Yeah.
$23,000 a year with a master's degree, too.
Oh, yeah. Or they wind up working in a field that's not even their study.
Right. Well, I've got a son-in-law that's got a PhD.
Yeah.
Okay? A PhD. He's working in a field that isn't even what he got his PhD in. And he didn't get a PhD in, like, literature.
No.
He got a PhD in the chemical process, cancer, something to do with cancer. Molecular biology.
Yep. So big,
molecular
big difference
biology.
And not even working in it.
Yeah, and he doesn't even work in it. So, and he's graduated now 2 years, and he applies every week. He's sending out anything. And you go, what is that value? Some of you may have college educations. I don't. I have my little bit of college because you go to paramedic. You get credits for police academy. But I don't have like a formal
degree.
I don't have an AS or a, let's see here. We're looking at your messages here real quick. I have a PhD, Jose says. Bowties and Hot Dogs is Jason finally in Tennessee. Post-hole digger PhD.
There you go.
Hey, brother, we get you. We get you. I'm more of that PhD, the post-hole digger PhD. What do you guys do when you're selling hot dogs on the street and you need to go to the bathroom? I go to the bathroom.
You go to the bathroom. Yep.
Yeah, I just close up. If it's something like that, I just close up. But usually I'm out there 2 hours, three hours.
It's all about getting your schedule down and, you know.
Yeah, not eating chili cheese fries
right before
20
service.
20 minutes before you start.
Yeah.
Or drinking a gallon of lemonade. But I've had to leave. I actually had a customer watch it for me while I ran in and used the bathroom and came back out. That was embarrassing for me.
Well, we've covered that on the
stuff. So I'm not going to get Jason's keeping me from getting sidetracked. I'd have started a whole nother webinar right there. Bathroom usage. Okay, so Oh, John says, hurry, need to get to work. John, bear with me. It's coming. Okay, here we go. Are you enjoying the webinar so far? I need to ask you that. Hopefully you are, and hopefully you answered.
Hopefully
yes, 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 okay.
Good. Right.
Yes, great. All right. I'm glad you are still with us here. All right, so here we go. So here's what we've covered real quick. I'm going to recap. I'm going to turn this off so you can see the whole screen. How the highest income earning vendors work less than the average vendor and what we have proven to be the fastest way to achieve it. We're going to give you more of that information in a minute and blow your socks off. Secret two, how to build up gigs and have money in hand before you even are ready to begin. We covered that thoroughly. How to make your business competition free. Covered that. And we've got more for you there as well. But let's move on here. So out of everybody here, I'd love it if you'd post in the comments, okay? If you can, if you're on a cellular device that won't let you comment, don't worry about it. I know there's some. We got some messages. So who wants to take things to the next level? Type in "I'm ready," okay? All you got to do is type in "I'm ready" into the comments. This is kind of more for my ego than anything. I just like to know that people are listening.
Yep, that they're still here listening.
Yeah, because otherwise I just turn it off and go have a bourbon and make a burger.
Yeah.
All right, there's a delay, see, so we're seeing it later. Oh, look, there we go. All right, so we got a lot of Wendy says yes, Don says yes, Kim says yes, Stacy says yes, Jason says yes, Cheryl, Antonio, Joe, Jim, Kristen, Carrie, Candace, Wendy, Tommy, thank y'all a bunch, Antonio, Jake. All right, I'm going to move on. All right, if I didn't call your name, don't be mad. So let's see here real quick. I went past my screen somehow. Just bear with me. All right, so here we go. Introducing, I love this. I love the name.
Yeah.
The Roasting Nomad Tribe Pack. And you're going, what is a tribe pack? Well, you're going to be a part of our tribe.
Yep.
Okay, if you take advantage of this, you're going to be a part of the tribe. But this gets so good, I'm going to talk fast because I know we've already run over time.
Yep.
And so we're going to do this as quick as possible. But some of it's important. We're going to give you some extra tidbits of information in this that you're going to want to be here for that you're not going to find anywhere else. So, but if you have to go to work, I completely understand. You got to go to work or something, go to work. I'm going to give you a replay. If you're on the email list, you're going to see the replay.
Yep.
Okay? Otherwise, it comes down. But I am sending everybody on the email list the replay link. Okay? Roasting Nomad Tribe Pack is all about, here's what it's all about, owning the catering industry in your community. You will own it. Okay? It's about building a real business that will reward you for a long, long, long time, okay, with real freedom, a great living, and even wealth, okay? Because could you expand without spending much more time, Jason?
Sure.
And make double money?
Yeah.
Triple the money?
Yeah.
At what point does it become where, okay, I've expanded to the point, it's kind of like me when I got to 22 carts, yep, it was way too much. I backed down to 6, made the same money, and spent less time.
I'm thinking 3 to 6 would be where I would probably stop because I just don't want to have to deal with more aggravation and more employees.
But you could have six. Let's say you did 4. You'd have 4 times the income.
Yeah.
Okay. And there's enough work in your town for that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, now, never have I seen, and I'm going to put me up here on the screen. I want you to see this because I want you to know I'm talking to you. Never have I seen a better way ever in my life to make this kind of money this easily with this little effort. You just talked about 12 hours max weekly,
yeah,
to make $2,400. I have seen these numbers. Jason, we have a group of private vendors that he shared his actual receipts, okay? So it's not a matter of, he photoshopped it. I've been up there, right? Twice? So a total of 7 days I've spent with you. Rode around with him because I'm the skeptic, remember? It's on my motorcycle and on my truck. Spelled different, but it's Skeptic.
Yep.
So, so what I've been sharing for 3.5 years, almost 4 years now, is catering. But what we found is the absolute best method to deliver that.
Yeah. Swiss Army knife.
It's the Swiss Army knife of catering. So, here's the deal. I'm going to shut this off so you can see the screen and tell you a little about this. Jason's going to help me with this too.
Working from home.
So we're going to talk. You can work this from home. Now, we already talked about commissaries with catering and stuff, but some states do not require commissary. Let me give you an example. Tennessee, okay, does not require a commissary for catering. So I can do a hot dog cart in Tennessee, and I got to have a commissary, but I can do anything I want as a caterer in Tennessee, no commissary required, as long as there's no sick kids in the home. I can use my own home kitchen. Now, not all states are like that, so some places will need a commissary. What is a commissary? Commissary is just a fancy word for commercial kitchen. It's just a commercial kitchen. That's all it is. So not a big deal. And it's easy to do. It can be done in a day. You can have it wrapped up in a half a day.
Yeah.
So talk about the red tape real quick.
Well, with the red tape, with catering, it's always less than doing a food truck, a hot dog cart,
right,
or a trailer. With the tribe, we're going to help them out there.
Right.
Giving them links. But it's always easier to cater than it is to street vend.
Right.
So less red tape, less aggravation for me.
Has anything changed in your business because of what we're fixing to show them? And y'all are seconds away from seeing something awesome, okay? Seconds away. Has anything changed in your mindset of where you plan going forward because of what we're about to show?
Yes. I've been able to cut my labor from 50 to 75% and make more money.
Did y'all hear that? 50 to 75%.
50 to 75%.
Labor.
Yeah, and I can send one person out. I can send one of my chef managers out with this unit. They can do up to 150 people by themselves.
Right.
So they go out in the box truck or the trailer with this unit, set up, serve, and leave and come back and clean up.
Yep.
Where that used to take me 3 to 4 people. I can do it one person now. And provide something that nobody else has.
Right. Right. Nobody has.
And menus that other guys aren't doing near me.
Yeah, but we haven't even gone into all the things you can do, yeah, which we're fixing to show you, okay? But you're going to be blown away with this is catering on crack.
Yes.
This is like speed catering.
Yes.
And if you want to, you don't even have to work it. Yep. And make the same money. Make the same money. So we got drop-off options, right?
Yeah.
Same with normal catering.
Yeah.
But this gives you more. It's eye candy.
Yeah.
More eye candy, yep. and more versatility. Okay? So you'll also get multiple opportunities with this. There's multiple income opportunities.
Multiple income streams, yeah.
Income streams.
Because of the different menus.
Different menus and the way you decide to cater.
And the way we can do it, yeah.
If you decide to cater, you could have 4 different ways you cater, different packages, and we're going to show you all that. Endless menus, literally.
Yeah.
Literally.
I'm still
coming up with new stuff. Could you give us just a quick one? Just a quick rundown.
Well, how about you want them all or just now? All right. So how about later today for the crew? We're doing seafood.
There you go. So we're doing seafood. You could do, could you do barbecue?
You can do barbecue.
Could
you smoke?
Could you do like a buffet?
You can use it as a hot buffet service.
Oh my gosh. Okay. So hot buffet service.
Swiss Army knife.
Could you smoke?
Yes.
You can smoke.
Yes, you can smoke in it.
All right. You ready? Huge profit margins. Huge. I'm talking not little bitty profit margins. No. These are huge.
Good profit margins catering with this.
And can you do this business? This is something we faced with the vendors, the street food vendors, year-round service.
Yes.
Okay? Definitely. Now, we have vendors that fight the battle in Canada, Alaska.
I'm one of them. I mean, yeah, you fight it. Ski resort right through the winter.
Right.
Yeah.
But we talk about blow heaters and all that. Do you need any of that for this?
No. I would say 10x10 tent would be good.
But can you go indoors?
Yes.
Do the whole thing indoors?
Yes.
You can do anything you want in any state. And guess what else? What we're about to show you has been approved in all 50 states.
Yep.
all 50 states.
ETL.
Okay? ETL certified, which is the same as NSF or UL or FDA Chapter 4. It's all the same thing. It's just a different company that puts the label.
Yep.
Right? And virtually no competition, because we showed you already and talked about, but I'm going to tell you more, how to... the competition is only for the people below you. The people that are trying to catch up, playing catch up, they're competing with the other people playing catch up. You're the leader in the pack. You're the Apple. You're the Google.
Yep. Let them follow.
All right. So, here we go. I'm going to show you something real quick, but I'm going to turn on this camera so you can see it. Now, look here real quick. Okay? And then I'm going to explain that screen if I can. Jason, do you care to explain this a little bit? Well, I'm going to move a little.
Our chairs out a
little
bit.
Yeah. All right. And the mic should pick you up.
All right. So this is the Nomad Roaster. So what we have on the one side on the doors is glass so we can see inside. So if I'm doing a pig or I'm doing a rotisserie with seafood or I'm doing chickens, they can see inside it. Now the other thing, we talked about a hot buffet. I can keep this door on. Ben would be on the service side. I could be standing on this back side with hotel pans in there and serve. So I'm going around the back here. And I'm serving Ben from this side, and Ben's looking at what's in the hotel pans here.
I can see everything here, all the hotel pans, so all your steam pans laid out across.
Everything's there.
This.
Yep, it's a hot buffet with a window, okay? I can do up to 180-pound hog in here. I can do a quarter leg of beef.
Well, you and I did how big a hog? Well, we did a lot of hogs.
Yeah, we did a lot of hogs.
But what was the biggest one we did the other day?
I think we did 120 or 130.
120, roughly, hog we did.
Yep.
But that was our second hog of the day. We started
that was for the charity event.
Yeah.
We started with a smaller one. We did like a 70 for a drop-off. So we did that one in the morning. Then we did the bigger one in the afternoon for the charity event.
Explain how that worked, though. We cooked hog.
Cooked the hog.
At home.
Cooked them.
And delivered it on a pan.
And delivered it on a large pan with these large pans. And,
but we actually had somebody else deliver it.
Yeah. My wife actually delivered that one.
So delivered the hog. Made the money, didn't have to be there, didn't have to carve, didn't have to do anything. It's not that, it's this. Oh,
this one, okay.
I'm going to raise it up a little bit. Y'all bear with me. I'm going to raise the camera up so you can see better. Tell me when we're good.
That's good. There we go. That'll be a little better. So,
how's that looking here?
That looks better. So we did the first hog of the day. That was a drop-off. Dropped that off with some rolls, some sauce, and I think coleslaw and potato salad for that one.
Right.
Dropped off, paid. Then we immediately started the next hog for later that night for the charity event.
Right.
So we popped the hog in here. Now, besides the hogs, we can do quarter leg of beef.
Now, let's tell them, how long does it take to do a hog, put it in here?
All right, so that 100, let's go.
How long did it take
60,
us?
60 or 70 pounder, I think that was 4.5 hours.
No, I'm saying how long did it take us to do the 120 pounder to prep it and to get it loaded?
30 minutes maybe to prep it and get it in the cooker.
But that was because we were filming
and, you know, doing some other stuff, so we're moving a little slower.
But normally
20 minutes to have a hog on the spit, dressed
and cooked,
scored and ready to go, turned on
and seasoned.
Yep,
ready to go.
Now that pig, that 120 took 5.5 hours.
Now cooked. Can I do roasted oysters in here?
Yes.
Can I do crab legs in here?
Sure.
In fact, we're going to do it later. We're going to bring you in on it.
We're going to
on
do a
Facebook.
Live
we're
going to
do a live Facebook. We're doing a whole seafood buffet.
You can do 40 roaster chickens. And if you don't need 40 for the party, you throw in veggies. We throw in corn on the cob.
There's your added value.
Added value. Bump it up. We're not just doing the chickens. We can set it up as a barbecue grill. So there's grates that'll go across here, and then steam pans on this side, so I can be doing hot dogs, chicken, and burgers here, and then dropping them in the steam pan to hold.
Right.
And again, here's our hot buffet service with a window. So, now, the other thing we can do, the quarter leg of beef is a whole other thing, but I took some of the clamps that hold, you know, that hold the pig. I can do turkeys. I can do hams, all in the
spit. With the same clamps.
Yep.
You could do several
large turkeys.
Several large turkeys, several large hams.
Yep.
You could do you can do smoked seafood.
Yep.
You could do smoke anything.
Yeah, because we have a smoker box. I soak my wood chips in water for about 30-40 minutes. Then I go ahead and I'll put that smoker box right down on the rail here. where the burner is, and stuff only takes smoke for the first 2 hours. After that, it's strictly heat to finish the job. So we can even do ribs in here. There's a rib rack. We can do butts. We can do brisket and smoke them and then finish cook them. We can do our rotisserie chickens. We
now, how does this roll? Like all terrain? Like, well, I can take it over the dirt, sand, rocks, out through my ditch in the yard?
Yeah, it's set up with tires, or about 10-inch tall tires, or pneumatic.
Pneumatic.
It's set up as basically a trailer or a wagon. I'll slide this back, and I don't know if you can see it there, but Ben's got the handle here.
There's your handle. You can tow this about anywhere. It's pretty easy. One person, even loaded with a hog.
Yeah, loaded with the hog. It rolls. It rolls easy. Right now, I'll take these doors down and I'll show you we're set up.
I need to. Hopefully, they can see that. I'm gonna make your screen a little larger, so you can see this real quick.
You want to grab that side, and we'll take this door down. We'll take the.
Now, the only reason that it took two of us right there is because
we have
a bench behind us. Where are we? We're on my deck.
We brought it up the steps.
We're up about 15 feet in the deck.
On a deck.
With this, and it only took two of us.
We brought up the steps without killing ourselves. You want to pull this out?
Yeah.
You lift down there.
Get this out of my way.
We'll go right in there. So now this would be what we call carving position. If it was a hog on the spit, the hog's going to go up here. We'll drop in a carving tray here.
These racks wouldn't be here.
This is set up right now for the rotisserie because we're going to be doing seafood later. But this is the rotisserie. These all move individually. And this spins and rotates around by a motor. So when Ben was up and we did that other job, I had the chickens in here. We trussed them, dropped them in. I seasoned them a couple different ways. This basket had the corn on the cob. This basket had all kinds of mixed vegetables,
zucchini, squash,
portobellos, pineapple. And this thing spins around in there. So this is how we're cooking the chickens. Now
we had a smoker box going.
Yep, did the smoker for the first little bit. Now these racks come off and we set up for the hog. And the pole you can kind of see in the middle here, same thing, except we would have the hog sitting here and we go right into carving at the party.
I'll take that off so they can see that.
So here's the pole. This is the same pole that would go through the hog with some clamps. We'd have two spine clamps in the middle. We'd have up here, we'd have brackets, little triangles that hold the legs front and back. But this is the same pole that the pig spins on. Okay? So, same pole, I had the rotisserie attachments and the baskets. It just took this piece of equipment, Swiss Army knifed it, and allowed me to do a rotisserie.
Right.
So instantly. Everybody thought, oh, it's just a pig cooker. Well, no, it's a pig cooker. It's a rotisserie.
A pig cooker is the least of what this does.
It's a smoker. It's a pig cooker.
Steamer. Buffet service. Literally, you have none of this, and you set your steam pans in.
Yep.
You can put your water pan in the bottom. You can even still smoke if you want to with it. And you have all that ready with the glass doors so your customers see here. But what Jason mentioned a minute ago that I wanted to bring up is you have all this going, you can literally take this to a customer's house, drop it off, you and I did this, and left and told them, hey, at 4:15, your pig will be done, just turn it off, here's the button.
Yep. So what I did for the drop-off was, we got the hog in the morning, Ben helped me, we dressed it, seasoned it, I scored it, had it on the pole, dropped it in the cooker, and it cooks down here, inside, these doors are coming up here. Told them what time to turn it on. It's just like a grill. They turn it on, they hold the burner for 15 seconds, and then go to high. Lift the other burner, they're done. Piggy starts turning. And it becomes the center point of the party because everybody wants to see what that shiny thing is. Right. What's it do? Oh, the pig's in there. Oh, it's cooking. It's spinning.
right.
So they wind up standing around this thing at the party. 4 hours later, when that hog's done, we told them, I give them big mitts to take it out with, and they put it up in carving position, and there was a guy there that happened to be a butcher. Remember, and he jumped up and started carving. He loved it.
Yeah. So and carving, let me, because Jason's
not really carving.
Yeah, yeah. It's mostly picking a pig.
Picking a pig, basically.
It's soft.
Yeah, you're going to cut the skin, take the crackle off, and then basically it's pulling the meat. You're not really carving it like a turkey. Everybody gets panicked. I know one of the guys said, oh my gosh, I can't carve a pig. Well, it's more like picking with some tongs.
Or with a three-prong fork.
Yeah.
Just
and
rake
just
it off.
Pulling it out. But when it's done, they put it up in carving position, We had a pan set up for them. We had rolls and everything there. And
they served themselves.
They served themselves, and the homeowner looks like a hero because he just did all this. He cooked this, and they kept saying, "Tom, you cooked this. Wow."
Wow. Yeah. And it is brilliant. And actually, in the one we just did, the one I just did with you the last time I came, where his wife took the pig, we had it all ready. Yeah. So we delivered it on a bed of kale,
yep,
on a big pan, a big sheet pan.
Apple in his mouth.
Pig made the same money. Just didn't have to be there and dropped off a pig. They picked their own pig.
Didn't even take the machine on site.
No, they never even saw the machine. Nope. So this has so many options, so many things that you can do with it. And I'm going to put back up this screen because I want to give you some of the values.
Okay, we need to go back to that.
Let me give you some of the values here, and that way you can see what we're talking about. Okay? You can see Jason there with the machine, but here's the deal. The pig roaster is, if you went and bought this pig roaster, it's $59.50 without any of the anything. Accessories, yep. Without a drop of anything. Okay? We're with this package with the Roasting Nomad team, the tribe.
Yep.
You get the pig roaster, you get the Pig Roaster Pro equipment pack, which is $1,065. Okay? You get the we have created, and I did this for a reason. Jason backed me up on this, and with several others. I did not want to just throw you to the wolves. I wanted to create a way, so this is big. So don't do this on a whim.
Yeah.
Do this if you're serious, because this will make you a lot of money, and it's very easy, and you don't have to actually work it if you don't want to. But what we did, we spent the last several months doing, is creating a members area, a package of training, a package of everything. Yeah. I mean, it's everything you could want to know about operating, how to do seafood in it, how to do a pig in it, how to prep a pig, where to buy a pig, how to source your spices, how to clean it. We've got everything for you already done, and that's in this part of the package, okay?
Even your state's contact for catering.
We give you everything, your state's contacts, everything you could possibly need, the pro training, fast start videos, the forms, the outline, the updates, and 365 day a year support, okay? So you can get a hold of support if you have a question or ran into a trouble, or maybe you got like multiple things going and don't know how to book it.
Yep.
You know, you need some advice. We'll help you with that. You'll also be a part of a wholesale buying group, okay, which includes discounts, including supplies and insurance. It's about a $2,200 value at a minimum. We took a low number because my attorney said we had to, okay? So there's your least amount you get off that buying group is $2,200. That's your value, real value. So your total real value is $13,415, okay? Which is a lot of freaking money.
Yeah.
That's a big value, right? So here's what I want to talk to you about real quick, and I'll do this quickly as possible and help you out through this. But y'all bear with me. I got to take a sip of my drink. I think I also pulled up the wrong screen. No, I still got it. I'm good. Okay, so disposable income, good versus bad debt, and you just have to bear with me through this because this is important information, okay? It's where I feel like I can deliver more value into your life. Even if you are just vending or you haven't thought about vending, I want to give you more value. It makes me happy and it makes me sleep good and it makes me wake up happy in the morning because I'm able to help people. There was over 16 new comments on YouTube this morning, just on YouTube, and many of those, and thanks, and it makes my day. But I want you to think about this. All of us have a disposable income. Most people get their paycheck each month or each week or every 2 weeks, and a percentage of that goes towards movies, candy, magazines, Starbucks, coffee, the latest, greatest iPhone, going out to dinner, and things like that. And so there is good debt and bad debt. And what I'm asking you to do is take some of that disposable income, some of that income that you're going to spend either way, not get anything in return for it, anything of value, other than the immediate gratification of going to Red Lobster for the, you know, for 30 minutes or an hour. And use that to better your life. Instead of blowing it on something temporary you're going to lose, right? I'm going to ask you to make an investment in yourselves, because the money you put into this is ultimately going to turn into more money for you, okay? I'm sure you've heard of Robert Kiyosaki, okay? He's a world-famous author, wrote the book Rich Dad, Poor Dad. In the book Rich Dad, Poor Dad, he talks about the difference between assets and liabilities. He said that poor people, they buy liabilities. They buy new cars, you know, every year. Got to get the newest, greatest to keep up with the Joneses. They buy the boats. They buy all the things you put your money in and the money disappears. What the rich people do is they put their money into investments that actually turn into more money, right?
Profit.
Yeah. All I'm doing is asking you to do is to divert some of the money, your disposable income, into an investment, into the Roasting Nomad Tribe Pack, as opposed to something that's going to take money away from you. Because you're going to spend money either way.
Yep.
Right?
Oh, yeah.
My dad has a saying, he goes, well, 6 months from now, it'll be 6 months later, where are you going to be? He also has another one, when really bad crap hits the fan, he goes, 100 years from now, it won't matter.
That's true.
True. Won't matter for me, but matters today. So here's what we're doing. Because you're on this webinar, and only because you're on here, okay, we're going to do a bonus. And it's a private one-on-one consult with me or Jason. And this is a real $600 cash value, and it's an actual value. I've had it on my website for about 5 years, and I stay booked about 3 weeks out, okay? You will get first priority, okay? But we can only do this for, well, we were going to do it for 10 people. Then I had a guy that was going out of the country. I shouldn't even told anybody, but he paid the $1,000 I told you about. And so, anyway, so I'm still going to do 10, which makes us 11. Okay? Yeah. 600 cash value, one-on-one consult. It's kind of like your like a get-started consult if you want, but you can use it anytime you want in the year. Okay? So I would prefer you use it as quickly as possible, not for my sake, for your sake, because you don't want to lose any momentum. So you want to get going with that. So Jason and I are going to do, we're going to give you that as well. And let me go back to the page so you can see this real quick. I know that so I'm going to give you this, a real $600 value, cash value. Okay. The next thing you're going to get is, well, if you only got that, I made myself a note here. This is how I stay on track. Otherwise, I'll be telling about my neighbor's cats. If you only got that, though, all of this is worth it. So basically, what you're going to get now, that value that was $13,000 a little bit ago, now you're at over $14,000. So you still get the pig roaster, which is like the, what do you call it?
Swiss Army Knife Cater and Equipment.
The Swiss Army Knife Cater Equipment. The Pig Roaster Pro Equipment Pack. 1,065 value. The Roasting Nomad Tribe VIP membership. 1 year. You get that 1 year already included. $1,200 value. Okay? And now no one can get that later at that price. They won't even get it for $100 a month.
No.
I'll guarantee you, because we're giving so much value in there. We can't possibly help enough people. So I'd rather do it where we can actually give value and give them our time and be honest with it, instead of saying, hey, well, I posted a picture on Facebook. Did you see my new meme? We can actually give you real value. Pro training fast startup videos I told you about earlier. You'll get all the forms, the outline, the updates, and 365 support. That's 365-day support. Wholesale buying group, okay? That's the $2,200 I mentioned a minute ago about my attorney. Said, you got to go with the minimum. You can't give them a max. It's actually more than that, but I have to tell you that. So now you're at $14,015, right? Money replenishes. Let me ask you a question real quick. Have you ever lost a substantial amount of money? Maybe you blew it, made a bad purchase decision or bad investment. I know I've done it. Jason, you ever done that?
Oh, yeah.
Have you, tell me, what's your worst one, Jason? What's the worst one you did?
When we first started doing the barbecue, buying those Traeger grills, they just didn't work. $3,000 for three of them, and
it didn't work.
Nah, didn't put enough smoke flavor in the meat, and computer problems, just nothing but aggravation.
I've made bigger ones than that. I once invested in software for my stores when I had furniture stores, and it was over $70,000 with a crew that came in to train all my people how to use it, and then it didn't work. They had bugs and bugs and bugs, and we couldn't even work it because we couldn't make the sale, so we were doing handwritten tickets just to make the sale,
just to get the sale
and then
done.
Trying to get it in there later. It was a nightmare. So I've made some bad decisions. This one is, would you say that there's any risk at all? Like, literally, other than them not doing it.
Well, if they don't do it, there's risk because they won't make any money, but I don't see how you cannot be booking jobs with this. There's just too much that you can do off of it to not book jobs.
So basically, money replenishes either way. What doesn't replenish? Time.
Yeah, can't replace that time. Missing the kids' recital, soccer game, seeing your wife, can't replace it.
Oh, almost ruined my marriage. When I had the furniture stores, I was working 70, 80 hours a week. I felt important. I had to be gone all the time. Yeah, everybody had money. My kids all had new cars, the ones that could drive. I had a brand new freaking tractor. I mean, I had everything that you could want. I had no time to use it.
Yep.
So what was all of it worth? And can I make money back? Yes. Can I make my time back?
Nope.
No. I missed out on part of my kids' lives because of my decision to do it the wrong way. I'm sure there's people listening right now that have done that, watching their kids grow up on Skype and FaceTime.
Yeah.
I've done it. It sucks. So money replenishes. Now I'm going to, y'all can tell I'm like a pro at this. Now, here's your next, maybe. I didn't pull up the right one. All right. So, bonus two. Oh, there's more to this. You're going to love this, guys. I hope you're staying with us because this is going to be mind-blowing what we're going to do. Jason and I have come up with a deal and a half. Okay? So, bonus two. Free commercial, U.S. Continental U.S. shipping. Okay?
That's
$387.
Huge.
Is the low end. I had to do the low end of the tourney thing again.
Yep.
Okay. $387 value, free shipping. Free shipping. You're going to get one of these machines with the accessories and everything I already told you that you're going to get, but I'll cover that again in case you missed it. Okay. Here's my little pitch on breaking old habits. You know, y'all have heard me say before, and I ain't the one that coined this phrase, but insanity is doing the exact same thing over and over again, expecting different results. You think, oh, it's going to change. Next year's going to be better. Oh, it's going to be better next year. But what did you change different? Nothing.
Well,
you wonder.
Going to be the same.
Next July, you're going, why ain't nothing changed? Well, what did you change? What did you change about anything? Nothing. So you get into this almost like a quagmire, and you have no way to figure out what you did wrong. So here's the my little spiel on this in brief. You've probably been to these kinds of webinars, right? Before, you've been to our training seminars. You get excited, you get fired up, and then what happens the next day? Probably nothing for most of you. And the truth is, it's sad. It's happened to me too, because I've shown you guys the exact system that Jason's used, that I've used, that Mr. Harris used, my dad's church buddies used, and we got several others, okay, to create a higher income, have fun, make more free time and more money. And you're going to go back tomorrow. You could, if you wanted, and do nothing. Nothing changes, right? That whole insanity thing. The reason why is because old habits, they're hard to break. And what I'm going to ask you is, would you like to change that? Change those old habits. The only way you're going to be successful is if we figure out a way to break those habits. The way you're going to break that habit is by investing in the change for yourself, by getting we've created a business in the box. Yeah, that's what we've created. It's ready to go. It's everything. We even are going to let them. You want to tell them you're going to let them use a licensing of
the name.
Yeah, you can use the name if you want.
Roasting Nomad.
Roasting Nomad. You can be a part of the crew, and you can still be Sevierville Roasting Nomads or Hillbilly Roasting Nomads or whatever you want it to be. But you get. You're going to have some national exposure.
Yep. A lot of people struggle with a name, you know, in the street vending business. It's one of the big things we hear week after week on the show. So now we've got a brand.
A brand that you can use freely as part of the package for your advertising, logos, content, everything. So when I told you we've been working on something amazing, this is something amazing.
And we're not done.
And now, I ain't even done here today. We're not done here. So I hope you're still with me. But now you're going to have the tools to break the habit and be able to take this to the next level. Okay? So, find my dang thing again. All right. Y'all bear with me. I get lost in this. And I have multiple slides up for notes. Jason, do you want to run through this real quick for them? Just to give them the overall value again, because we just increased the value.
So, basically, you're getting the pig roaster, the mobile cooking center, right, for $5,900. I'm sorry, $5,950.
That's if they paid retail for it.
That's just retail, right?
For basic.
Yep. Then you're getting the pig roaster pro equipment pack valued at $1,065. You're getting the Roasting Nomad Tribe VIP membership for 1 year valued at $1,200. You're getting the pro training, fast start videos, forms, outline, update, 365 days a year support. That's a $3,000 value. You're getting the wholesale buying and discounts on supplies, insurance, spice rubs, things like that. That's a $2,200 value. You're getting private one-on-one consult with myself or Ben. That's a $600 value. You're getting free continental U.S. shipping. $387 value. So now we're up to $14,002.
$402.
Oh, I'm sorry, $14,402. Seems like a lot.
That's a whole lot.
It's a whole lot of money.
Okay. Bonus three. We got more.
There's more.
Go ahead.
All right. Bonus number three. After you get started, we're going to do a 3 to 6 month private progress consultant, consultation session with Ben or Jason. Can't even talk. I'm so excited. That's a $600 actual cash value.
Now, I actually had to twist your arm, and this is only for the first 10.
Yes,
this
first 10.
This is first 10 only, okay, because I had to twist Jason's arm for this one.
So now what we're going to do is whenever you feel you're ready, somewhere between 3 and 6 months after getting started, you're going to call and set up the consultation, and we're going to go over everything with you, how to expand, maybe new menu options, whatever it may be, that's included.
So that we can make you more money. And it comes with this.
Yep.
It comes with this. You're going to get this as part of being in the
tribe.
Roasting Nomad Tribe. Okay? How cool is that? So, the bottom line is you can make money. You can make money your excuses. I love this. And y'all may have heard me say this before. But for the last hour or so, we've shared a ton of information with you. But as you know, information alone is not going to save you. It's not going to change your bank account. You need the Roasting Nomad Tribe. Business in a box. I'm telling you, ready to go. That's what's going to help you get to where you want to be, period. Look at it this way. People in life, they have one of two things. They can either have money or they can have excuses. Is that not the truth?
It's true.
Every time. That's it, okay? So right now you've got two options. Option one, you can sign up now and can direct your own life and create a higher income with less time. Or option two, you can come up with some excuse, and I've done it, okay? Jason's done it.
Oh, yeah.
Why you can't afford it, why you couldn't do it this time, why you don't have enough time, whatever your excuse is today, that's fine. But the reality is you can't have both. You can have money, or you can have excuses. And you've got to decide right now which one you want. And I don't know about you, but I'd rather have money. So that's what you need to do is go and invest in this, because we're going to help you. You're going to get more help than you couldn't get this much help if you bought a McDonald's franchise for how much is a McDonald's franchise? Heard $1 million.
Oh, God, easy.
And that's without the building or anything.
Yep. That's without the build out. That's just licensing.
Right. And what is the average McDonald's store owner making his first year? A little over $100,000, according to Inc. magazine.
Yeah, if you're lucky. You're not really making money till you have several.
Right. Right. So, let me do this, and I'm going to do this quickly for you, okay? And I appreciate your patience, and I hope this is of value. I hope that you have grabbed the nuggets of stuff in here, and it's helped you today. This is a recap again. You get the complete Pig Roaster Pro Commercial Mobile Cooking Center, $59.50, right? The Pig Roaster Pro Equipment Package, the pack that me and Jason picked out to be the best to start with. The Roasting Nomad Tribe VIP Membership, $1,200 value. All the training, all the videos, the forms, and it's going to be updated every week. Okay? We got so much stuff coming your way. 365-day support, that's a $3,000 value. Wholesale Buying Group, $2,200. I told you before, my attorney said I had to put it at the low end. I'm telling you it's worth more than that. I'm not allowed to say legally.
Mm-hmm.
It's worth more. I can just tell you that. It's $2,200 value, though. Private one-on-one consult with me or Jason. Free shipping, $387 value. And a 3 to 6 month progress private consult with us again. Okay? $600 value. Now you're at $15,000.
And two.
Yeah, you could go buy a car almost.
Yeah.
Or half a car.
It's a lot of money.
It's a lot of money. A lot of money. So, this is my goodbye. But you're not done. So stay here with me.
Hang on.
Just hang on. Just a couple more minutes with me. Okay? Because I want to share something with you real quick. This is the deal. All you have to do is I gotta find my thing again. All you have to do is I've been trying to all of us, we try to direct our own lives. We try to create higher incomes with less time. And I've been preaching this for 9 years with vending. I want you right now to say it with me. Say goodbye. Say goodbye to driving trucks for a living or being a corporate executive who makes great money but can never see his kids or his wife. And maybe he's on his third, I've been happily married 3 times. And I'm pretty much at fault for the first two. So you watch your kids grow up through Skype. Goodbye to trading. Say goodbye to trading your time for dollars. Okay? As far as we know, we have a real bona fide evidence, okay, is you live once.
Yeah.
That's all we know for sure, right?
Yes,
we live
true.
Once. Are you going to live it working your butt off, missing out on life, this one life that we know we get, never having any free time or freedom with the hope that one day, things will be different? Will you make that choice? And better sooner than later? Change what you're doing now and live the life you want now. I do. I've helped many others. I help still to this day. That.
Oh, yeah.
And there's people listening right now that know I do. Hellfire, I have a proof of thousands doing what I've taught to get exactly the results I said they'd get. And many have gotten even better results. Your example.
Yeah.
You've gotten way better results. The bottom line, you are one thing, one purchase, one investment, one step away from changing everything in your life. Just one. When you join the Roasting Nomad Tribe right now, you can say goodbye forever to what's been stopping you and making your life an endless cycle of the same. Okay? And that's all I'm asking you to do. And Jason and I, you know how people think, oh, well, they're lucky, they got lucky, they're like heroes. No, we're not heroes. There's nothing hero about us, right?
No.
The truth is that I'm nothing special. I wasn't born with, a silver spoon in my mouth. If anything, it was a plastic spoon.
Yep.
I don't know about trading, I didn't know about trading time for dollars. I did it. I did it for years and I made great money in the furniture business and I spent years of trial and error to discover this thing that works super, super easy. Okay? It's super easy. And you can either go and do it the hard way and go figure it all out for yourself, or just do what I did and just plug it in. Plug in this information and you're guaranteed success. I've vended good days, bad days, and over time I've learned more and more. I've been sharing and teaching for years, and I continue to learn. Never in my life have I come across something with so much better than all these old ways. This is the new way you can get ahead of it all. Right now, you can join us and grow and earn as much as you want, all the while enjoying more freedom, more money. I'm nothing special. I'm just a normal dude. Y'all know, especially the ones that followed the podcast and stuff. I'm nothing special. And if you can do it, okay, and if I can do it, basically, you can do it. Guaranteed. Yeah. Guaranteed. Okay? I struggled with third grade, and I ain't joking. I promise you, you can do it. And the Roasting Nomad business in a box is what can make this a reality for you now. So, here's the deal. One more time. One more again, as I like to say. Jason, run through that real quick. Just sum it up.
Sum it up. You're getting the roaster, the Probe Pack equipment. You're getting the tribe membership, the training, fast start videos, wholesale buying group, one-on-one consult in the beginning, one on the 6 month. You're getting the free shipping. So we're at $15,002. A lot of money. It's a lot of money.
A lot of money. Y'all ready to know what we're going to do for you?
That's it today.
Get started right now with the Roasting Nomad Tribe Pack for $89.90. Okay? Now, you can come back and get this later. Okay? And we even have a financing plan set up. But you can get this right now for $89.90. RoastingNomad.com/tribe. And you can come back later. You can come back 6 months from now. Get the same price. You just won't get any of the bonuses.
Yep.
Okay? It'll be less stuff. The bonuses were a trial for us to work out.
Yeah.
Because of time. Okay? It's time because I don't want to give up fishing time. Jason doesn't want to give up. He likes his freaking waterboard and stuff.
the paddleboarding.
Yeah, paddleboarding. Waterboarding is something they did in Guantanamo, isn't it? I spoke wrong. So you can get started right now with this for $89.90. And you go, how many businesses, Jason, can you start for $89.90 and make $2,400 a week, $2,000 a week? What if you only made $1,000 a week? Yeah. You can make $1,000 a week doing one job a week, right? And we're going to give you all the information to make that happen, and make it happen immediately. But how many businesses can you buy?
None.
I don't know of any business you can buy and have immediate success. In fact, you could say, Ben, Jason, I got to test this out first. Well, we showed you how.
Showed you how.
Test it out first.
Put it on Craigslist. Put it on Facebook. Don't spend a dime.
Don't spend one dime. Test it out. Watch what happens.
See what kind of response you get.
It accidentally happened is what's going to happen.
That's what's going to happen.
So that's the deal. So you've got two choices. You can change your life or you can stay in the same rut. It's the whole insanity plea. You know, do nothing and nothing changes. Change and either way, time's gonna go by. $89.90. I'm not gonna even pretend that isn't still a lot of money.
Still a lot of money, but we've got financing.
But what else did we do though? We added so much value that you could go directly to the manufacturer and buy 10 of them and not get the same value.
No, because we've added a lot of things that they don't even do.
Because we wanted to ensure your success. That's the bottom line. I wanted to, Jason wanted to ensure your success with this business. So you get all that stuff, okay? I'm not going to run through it again. I know you've already heard it, okay? But you're talking $15,002 in value, and that's minimum. Because I have an attorney that made me do everything at the low side. So that's your minimum value right there, okay? And you can have all of that right now for $89.90. RoastingNomad.com/tribe. The page is up right now. It's live right now. You can go there right now, okay, and check it out. And even on there, I go through back through. Yeah. Jason and I have outlined it, everything you're going to get, everything. Remember, though, first 10.
Yep.
First 10, okay, get all the extra bonuses.
Yep.
Because we can't.
Can't do it for everybody.
It's just simple fact of life. You can't.
There's only two of us. There's only so much time.
Yeah. There's only so much we can do. Now a lot of people will get the added benefit of being in the membership where they'll get videos and stuff like that. And we're going to even record some of the private consults if they allow us to share those. But you'll be able to gain off of that. But the first 10 actually get the private consults and the bonuses. $89.90. And even without the bonuses, though, you're still $7,000. $7,000 less than you could go buy that for.
Yep.
So I hope you do it. It's get started. Okay. It's roastingnomad.com/tribe. roastingnomad.com/tribe. You can go there now. And it'll be simple and easy and painless. We have a credit card system set up there. I've got the Q&A there, so if you're going, okay, how long does it take? Typically, I'll ship you a unit within about 24 hours. You'll have it in 3 to 7 days, depending on where you live.
Yep.
And you'll have immediate access to the information where we give you some added information for the tribe members, how we created business overnight. Before we even had the unit. And we tested this with several people. So before you even have your unit, you're going to have money. You're going to have made money because you can collect the deposit
30%, and set
it up.
30%.
Set it up. So we're going to hook you up with that. Let's see here. I'm looking through this stuff real quick for you. I want to make sure I don't miss anything. I know that... that this has been a while, but you know, this was important. This was a big deal.
Yeah.
This changed, life changing.
Yeah.
It's changing yours. Will you share, do you care to share just a little bit about where you think you're headed because of this?
Basically less truck and trailer work and more catering with this unit, which is hard to believe because you guys have watched what I've done. Those of you that follow us. And,
You're not struggling for money.
No. But I'm losing time.
There you go.
Less time with my kids, less time for dinners, less time for lacrosse, paddleboarding with the kids, or waterboarding, as Ben calls it. So for me, it's all about changing that. And if I can cut my labor and make more money, I'm all about it. And it gives me more freedom to be with the family, more time, even more so about it.
Right.
So...
Right now, you may have no idea how to get past the trading time for your dollars or having no real freedom. But later, after you invest in this, okay, and you're investing into the Roasting Nomad, something that pays off. What did we do the math on?
50-person party?
16 weeks, wasn't it? No. For this to be in the black.
Eight events or 10 events? It's so hot out here, I can't think.
Yeah, it is hot. Either way, it was a short time you could be in the black. I don't know of any business you could start and be in the black as quick as you can with this.
Yeah.
And have freedom. And we've done all the hard work for you. We've done the research. We've done the testing. We've got video training. We've got video training all the way down to cleaning scrubbing a hole.
Yeah.
And how long did that take? We filmed it and it took
a little longer.
22 minutes, yeah. I think.
But you can get it done in 15.
There you go.
So.
And that was without pre-soaking.
Yeah.
So, so you can change everything right now. All of these problems, they just evaporate, okay? And you direct your life on creating a higher income and working less. That's the power of this. So here's the reward. Remember, I promised the reward, right?
Yeah.
So we got to find out who stuck around. I know I'm impressed. We're right at 2 hours.
Yep.
We went a little Jason over. Asked me how long. I said probably an hour, hour and 10.
Yeah.
And a little over. We're about 50 minutes over. So for those of you that stuck around, Here's how to get your catering on a budget blueprint, I promised you. Okay? And I thank you for being here. You're the only one that's getting this. LearnHotDogs.com/catering-blueprint. Okay? I'm leaving this on the screen for you so you can see it and you can go there. Now I want to pick a cash winner, right?
Woohoo!
All right, who's still with us here? Who's still on here? Oh, we got I'm here's. Look at this. Love it, love it, love it. All right, I'm going to let you post up if you're here. Let me know you're here. And then we have somebody working in the background that's going to tell, hey, Chris, thank you, brother. I know it took a while. Chris has been waiting for this.
Yeah.
And I'm glad that he was able to be here. I hope you got value out of it, Chris. And I want y'all to know something. If you don't even do this right now, we gave you enough information. I hope you watched
yeah.
and paid attention. That you can do catering without anything, without any equipment.
Yeah.
But what we're giving you in this package is a business in a box, instant catering. Bam, you're done. You show up with this, with a hog roaster, you are in business. In business. Okay, so who are we going to pick here? Hold on just a second. I'm not going anywhere, guys. I've got like six programs to run this, and I'm letting them know that they can quit the recording on some of this because this part doesn't need to be recorded. Just bear with me. Let's see here. I got on the wrong. There it is. Okay. So I'm going to put me and Jason back on for you. Because who doesn't want to see me and Jason, right? If you're wondering, write this down in case you... let me clear this. That's your catering blueprint. And then I'm going to show you. All right. Oh, that camera moved.
Yeah.
All right. So here's the deal. We'll go. Let me move that camera down. Tell me when we're good.
That's good.
About good?
Yeah.
All right, you should be able to see us now. I have the camera raised. I'm gonna turn that. Let's see. There you go. And then I want to give you the link again real quick. There's the link. All right, so there's the link if you didn't get that, roastingnomad.com/tribe. I want to thank you for being here.
Thank you, guys.
It's been awesome. I know you're up there now. Yep. We had to raise the camera.
We had to raise the camera to get this in, but we appreciate you guys coming out.
Let's see here.
Who are we picking?
Well, Heather's supposed to give us a name. She's doing that randomizer thing.
Okay.
I'm waiting. Hold on just a second. Where in the heck? Hey, thank you, Wendy. Wendy says the logo's cool. Me, Dogwood Trees. All right, thanks, Ben and Jason. Thank you, Candace. Watering at the mouth, Boyd. I love the watermelon. Love the watermelon. Cheryl says, holy moly, awesome job, guys. Thank you, Jim. This was a labor of love because
yeah.
I wanted to give you enough information and value that you could do this on your own. And I'm giving you the blueprint to get it done. That's what the link is for. The link I gave you just a minute ago. You go get that, and we've written it out for you so you can get this done without spending a dime. You can test this. But for those of you who want this opportunity of a business in a box, go to roastingnomad.com/tribe and get it. Yeah, it's an investment. It's definitely an investment.
But we do have financing.
I've spent way more on less.
Yes.
Got way more for...
Like I say, Swiss Army knife, all the different things it can do. And that's just what I've done so far in 6 months.
Yeah.
Need some more time.
And wait till we show them tonight.
Yeah. Yeah,
we're doing gonna be good. We're doing some awesomeness tonight.
Yeah, we'll come back with a live shot of that.
Yeah, family reunion at Cheryl's place. Love it. All right, so hold on. Let me see what my message is. Y'all got to bear with me. I got to find this message from Heather. I don't know why this is on a different page.
Because we're professionals.
Yeah, we're professionals. We're like magic. All right, so.
All right, so the winner of the $100 card.
Veronica.
Navarez. Sorry if we mutilated that.
Yeah, I apologize if that was horrible. me no speak en español. Me speak poquito español.
I barely speak English.
Yeah.
So,
so anyway, Veronica Navarez.
Navarez. Yep.
Veronica Navarez, you win.
$100 Amazon
gift card. All you got to do is email support@roastingnomad.com. support@roastingnomad.com. And
awesome.
And that should be all we need. I think all we need is your email address.
Yeah.
I think it's it.
Yep.
And Amazon will deliver that to you. We don't even need your physical address, just your email. So email us at support. And thank y'all for all being here.
Thank you guys for your time.
Nick, Veronica, Jerry, Ray, Corey. Oh, look, Corey's here.
Corey Lawrence?
Corey's trying to get a paycheck out of this.
Oh, man, he was late again.
Late again.
It's going to be reflecting his permanent record.
That's right. Cheryl's here. Ned Sellers here. John's here. David's here. Keith's here. Thank y'all for being here. Appreciate it. Hope y'all have a good one. We enjoyed it. And I hope you got the value out of it that you expected. If we can help you any, please feel free to email us.
Yep.
And we'll help you further.
Thank you, guys.